Hello and welcome everyone. So we have covered the few questions in the previous slides about like set 1, set 2, set 3, set 4. Every set was having 10 questions. So here is the solutions you can find. This is actually a Medium blog where you can find the detailed answer of each and every question. It's not like I'm having only the few lines about the answers. Like if you talk about the first question, what is NPM on and how it is being used with Node.js. So I wrote the detailed answer of this question so that a beginner can understand, so that advanced Node.js developer can understand it. So what is NPM is a package manager, and it is managing the dependencies through the package.json. Then question two, why we should use a Node.js? Node.js can be used whenever we are actually writing the real-time application which we want to scale, and application which is single-threaded and can handle the thousands of the traffic, thousands of the concurrent requests. In those scenarios, we should always choose Node.js for our primary development, but we should not choose Node.js for CPU-intensive, memory-intensive applications. Okay, Node.js is actually providing the faster way of developing the REST APIs, and it has a good stack of library supported. You can see in the npmjs.com, you can see the lakhs, millions of libraries are out there, right? Another question is like, what is a Node.js stack? Node.js is built on top of V8 runtime engine, and there are two libraries, libev and libio. These are some thread, one is managing the thread and libev is managing the event loop. So Node.js is managing the event loop by the external libev library. Its event loop is not part of V8 runtime engine. Okay, so it talks about everything about this libev and libev library, the Node.js architecture. What is a Node.js architecture, how this event loop is, that event loop is single threaded, managing the IOs, different asynchronous operations coming in. So we already know that Node.js is non-IO blocking by design. So if multiple asynchronous requests are coming in, then it is pushing all those requests to the event loop, and event loop is processing one by one. Okay, then explain in depth about in event loop, how it is working. So there is an event loop, event queue mechanism. You can read in detail about it here. Then what are the NPM scripts? NPM scripts is the best way of writing the automation. Like if you wanted to write the test cases and you wanted to write a single command, NPM run start, NPM run test, NPM run build, all these NPM script will go inside the script tag of package.json. So NPM scripts actually replaced this grunt and gulp task runner tool. So this is the other way where you can have the task runner. Here you can put the hooks also, pre-hook and post-hook, like npm run deploy. There can be a pre-deploy, post-deploy script you have added, you can add here. What is event-driven? Node.js is an event-driven non-IO blocking programming code, because Node.js is event-driven. There is some event is happening and it is responding to that event. Even if you talk about the simple HTTP server, that is also event-driven. HTTP server is up and running in an event loop, and whenever the request is emitted from the client and being received by the server, then the request event is triggered and it will respond to that request. Okay, so there is a event detections, event handler or event emitter. These are the concept where from one place you will be emitting the event and at another place you will be handling that event. Okay, how Node.js V8 runtime is different on the console and different on the Node.js. So on the console, we have the only core based library of V8 runtime engine. Node.js is using the V8 runtime engine with libev and libio and the crypto libraries and having the Node.js bindings. So V8 is just a browser environment, but Node.js is a browserless environment. We don't have a document object there, window object there. It is just a CLI based tool which is running your operations. Okay, similarly, what are the different synchronous function, asynchronous function? Every operation is asynchronous. If that is reading something from the database, that is reading something from the file, that is making some network request, all these things. Okay, what are the timeout events, like set timeout? What are the different options to write asynchronous code? You can write a set timeout, basic timer event. You can write a basic callback, you can use async module, you can use the promises, you can use these async library, Bluebird library, Q libraries, and better you can write a promise or enhanced version of that is async await. Okay, this is set one. Similarly, you have set two of the questions. These are all important questions which I faced in the interviews, which I ask in the interviews, and which you will also face in the interviews. How single-threaded Node.js handles the concurrency when multiple IO operations happening? Like, I'm hitting 1,000 requests for a single API, then what actually is happening on the Node.js server? Node.js has a limit that it can hit, I think, multiple 1,000 requests per second, Node.js single process. But we always have multiple Node.js instances so that we can have the internal load balancing and can serve thousands of the requests per second, right? So the request is triggering, and this event loop, which is running as a single threaded environment, it is queuing the asynchronous request in the event queue, and from event queue, we are processing all the requests one at a time inside an event loop. For each and every request, we are managing a thread pool. This is a POSIX thread pool, which is being managed by the libuv library, which is creating the thread pool for each and every request. What is a Node.js callback and how it is helping us to run the asynchronous task? You can take an example of fs.read file, where first argument is the file name and second argument is the callback. I can zoom this in a little bit. I explain the basic asynchronous APIs in JavaScript, like set timeout, set immediate, set interval, clear timeout. All these are important timer events, and people don't sometimes misunderstood between what is a set immediate, what is a set timeout. So just go through it. Set immediate and set timeout are like event loop mechanism. Whenever you hit set immediate, it actually put your execution after whatever being executed in the event loop currently. It's not putting that in the QQ so that it will get processed later, but it is set immediate, okay? Put it immediately after whatever is being executed currently, okay? Then redeval print loop, node REPL, which is just like the console we are having, right? Which is actually reading your instructions and sending the output. This is the Node.js command line. What are the important Node.js modules? Like cluster modules, which is helping us to create the fork of the Node.js process, and we are creating the child of the Node.js process to run any sub process. Then crypto, DNS, domain, events, FS, HTTP, OS, path. These are the important modules. Similarly, I explain the events. Node.js is event driven, and we have the events module using which we are creating the event emitter, and we are emitting the event and handling that event. How can we read the file in synchronous way and asynchronous way using FS module? So FS is providing both the way, read file. This is a synchronous implementation. Read file as sync. This is a synchronous implementation of the same module. Same thing, how to capture the command line argument. How we execute the command in Node.js, node, file name, and these are the argument we are passing, right? So at the runtime, you can get all these variables using process.argv. This is the variable, this is returning an array containing all the argument which you are passing in the Node.js command line, right? What is the error check, error first check callback handler? So whenever we are writing callback, then we always check if the callback function is returning error, then deal with the error first instead of dealing with the response. So you should always do the error check first. Then what are the different module pattern in JavaScript? We can see the common JS is the module pattern which we are using in JavaScript. Other than that, we have UMD, AMD, ES6, all these different kind of module patterns. That's it. In second video, I will cover the rest of the questions. So you can also go through this Medium blog and can understand more.